everyone. Good afternoon and welcome to Exchange for Media webinar today in association with Quora, where we'll be talking about decoding target marketing, how to grow your brand with Quora. Marketing professionals like you know the challenges involved in reaching the right persons at the right time. And in today's session, what our speakers will be doing is decoding target marketing for you. May I please invite, before I invite Gurmeet and Vishal, I have a request for the audience. Please send in your questions in the Q&A box. We will be taking questions at the end of the session, so we encourage you to send in as many questions as you can. We also request you all to please keep your mics and your cameras off at all times so that it doesn't disturb our panelists. Now to get started, may I please invite Mr. Gurmeet Singh, General Manager, APAC Quora. Thank you so much, Vishal, for joining us. Over to you, Gurmeet and Vishal.
Thanks, Michelle. Very good afternoon to everyone on the call. It's a pleasure to have you on this session. So a quick, on this quick note, a quick history of Wavemaker. When two of the largest agencies of Group M, Maxis and MEG, merged in 2017 to form Wavemaker. Vishal moved from Maxis to take up the VP Wavemaker role and now the Chief Digital Officer at Wavemaker. Vishal is one of those few people who kind of transited digital transformation from one era to another era. And he's kind of seen a lot of, stuff happening in the digital age. And we are very lucky to have him on the call today. Welcome again, Vishal.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Worked across industries, auto, FMCG, telco, media, retail, name it. And, you've virtually seen it all. Just for the benefit of the audience to, name some of the key clients you've handled are L'Oreal, Mondelez, Mother Dairy, Tata Beverages, Bisleri, IPC Foods, MTR, Vodafone, Mintra, Netflix, Red Bull, Croma, Tata Motors, Kotak, NMIMS, and the list is very, very long. So it's great to have you on the call and, benefit from your experience. So without much ado, Vishal, my first question to you is, the last time we spoke and we spoke about, data and tech becoming the two most important and the strongest pillars in digital advertising. And
that's right.
You mentioned something about, precision marketing, which you guys do. So can you share with all of us what precision marketing entails? What is it all about?
Sure, Gopit. Just to put things in a bit of context, right? So when you look at the shift that we're currently observing, and the shift that we're observing is more from a landscape of, from a tech perspective, right? The shift is largely from the lens of media money is actually moving from platforms to audiences, right? There's a reason for that. So what we're noticing right now is that a lot of the clients and a lot of our clients, basically, and advertisers are looking at how is it that I can get the best buck for my media investments and so on and so forth, right? So when you look at it from that lens, the traditional way of doing that was you put money on various platforms and you see which platform is actually working for you. But now what we're seeing is that instead of putting it on platforms, you're looking at audiences and audience sciences, basically, right? So if it's a beauty brand that's looking to target women, so you'll have multiple tribes over there. Right? So you'll have tribes of, when I call a tribe, I mean an audience segment over here. It'll be a working mother, or it'll be, for instance, a housewife or a first jobber and so on and so forth, right? How do you identify these tribes and see which tribes working for you on which platform? And I think we do that, and the only way that one can do that is by integrating a good amount of the existing data practices that the client might have at their end with a certain amount of tech spine that they will be building at their end to ensure that basically they look at your existing first-party data that you currently have and enrich it with third-party data and create the right kind of audience sciences that you can look at targeting and so on and so forth. Yeah. And what we're noticing is that when we start creating these audiences and precisely communicating to how you'd communicate to a housewife versus how we'd communicate to an office-going woman, to how we'd communicate to a first jobber and so on and so forth, or to someone in the later half of the teens, the communication will differ a lot. And that's what we mean by precision marketing, right? So how you precisely communicate to an individual in the right context, in the right environment by using data and technology in the right context, yeah. And what we're noticing is that there's a good amount of increase in ROI, right? So across where we've deployed precision marketing and audience sciences, we're seeing an uplift of at least about 15 to 20% in terms of ROI. So either we are getting better, a much better bang for the bucks, or we're able to kind of reach more amount of people through the limited kind of spends that they currently had. Yeah. So maybe that in a sense is we're trying to kind of to summarize basically, right? That would be the core crux of precision marketing, how we're going about it basically.
Yeah, I think you've explained it very, very well. Just to add on to that, like, for example, I love the word tribe, which you used, you know, I think that's a great word. And to build on that, Quora, for example, has very unique ways of identifying the tribe. So we have something called topics. So, you know, depending on those topics, right, you can, you know, define your TG and the tribe, you know, which you've used. We have something called keywords through which you can actually identify. And obviously, we'll talk about it in this webinar. So any more examples that come to your mind of unique ways of precision marketing? You know, one is the usual demographics and all of that. Is there any other brand which you remember which kind of leverages anything which is unique in nature in terms of targeting?
Yeah, there are multiple examples of these sorts. Yeah. So for instance, if you look at the auto category, right? So I'll give examples pre-COVID and post-COVID also. So from a pre-COVID perspective, you know, you would look at identifying, let's say, for example, there's an auto category like an auto player like Ford, for instance. So Ford would look at looking at multiple dealers across the various parts of the country and identifying people who are predisposed to buying or market intenders, rather, people who are having some intent towards purchasing a Ford within that vicinity. So how do you layer your existing data that you currently have from the people who recently bought Ford? How do you layer that with third-party data? And identifying who are the people precisely you need to target within a certain vicinity. So the person you'll be talking to, someone in Kandivali in Bombay, for instance, will be completely different from how you'll be talking to someone in Gurgaon, yeah, right? And then also trying to understand the interest layers of that person over there to figure out if the person is interested in the looks of the car, then how you kind of communicate to him with the kind of looks or rather the visual appeal to the car. If someone interested in mileage, then how would you talk to him on the lines of mileage and so on and so forth. So how do you customize a communication to an auto buyer for the location that the person is present in, with the kind of interest behavior that is going on online, with the kind of demography also for that matter. Yeah. So how do we layer all these kind of data segments and data assets basically to kind of ensure that? So similarly for other categories also, whether it's a CPG category, every single category right now, if it's a telecom category, we're looking at prepaid versus postpaid, right? How do you talk to a prepaid person versus a postpaid customer? You know, if it's retail also, you'll talk about within the existing retail outlets that are currently there, how would you kind of ensure that you drive walk-ins to the store, and who's the most likely person to walk into the store by using a bit of AI and ML to kind of understand of the four people that I've targeted, who's the right person who will be walking to the store, and how do I expose them a little bit more, and so on and so forth. So there are multiple ways in this can be done. But I guess the crux of it all would lie on basically how well you intelligently use data and technology to do that. Yeah.
Sure. That's very useful. So Vishal, let's talk about the full funnel approach for a few minutes. So the full funnel, as you know, is, you know, there's awareness, there's consideration, and you know, at the end there's like performance, you know, hardcore performance. So traditionally, you know, digital media started off as a bottom of the funnel, which is completely used for performance. But as kind of digital That's media right. grew in terms of numbers and all, and now we find advertisers are adopting digital for a full funnel approach, from awareness to performance. So That's what right. are your That's views right. on that, and any examples there?
Yeah. So I was just doing this little bit of an exercise recently to kind of understand how digital budgets are actually being utilized online, right? And interestingly, if you look at it, for every $100 being spent on media, close to about $30 is actually getting spent on digital, right? And within that $30, if you look at it, essentially, within that $30, there'll be a good amount of people who are in the SME space, which we consider the unorganized market. And then there's the agency spend that's currently there, which is considered as the organized market, right? So the entire SME spend essentially is focused towards immediately driving ROI, bottom funnel, basically, right? And within the organized spends, it's an even split between top funnel and bottom funnel. That used to be the conversation pre-COVID as such. So if I could draw close, about 55% of the split would be on top funnel and basically the 45% of that would be on bottom funnel. And now what we're noticing is that 45% is becoming close to about 65% as we move forward, right, after the COVID situation and so on and so forth. One of the reasons for that is that even if you look at the top funnel players, they're largely driven by CPG brands, right? So if you look at all the CPG brands now, trying to see how is it that I can do a full funnel kind of an approach, and what is it that I can drive? How is it that I can actually drive through the funnel marketing, basically. So it's no longer about, you know, how do I kind of reach the right, what is no longer a conversation about RNF or the reach and frequency as such. But it's all about trying to see if I can reach X amount of people, how many of them have actually converted, right? And that's a conversation that we're seeing right now across all our brands, right? So across the CPG brands or any other brands that have been focusing on top funnel. And that's where I see a shift that's happening from conversation that is predominantly skewed either in the bottom funnel saying, okay, how many leads and how many acquisitions can I get, to a conversation where saying how many people can I reach, and now to a more ambidextrous conversation, which is about how many people can I reach and how many people of them are actually converting and how do I kind of draw a full funnel approach. That's a shift that we're currently seeing right now.
Yeah, Vishal, I think it's interesting to know the stats which you shared and the logic. So, you know, I can go on and on. I have a lot of questions, but we have other panelists as well. Before we kind of sign off, sure. Is there anything else you would want to add, Vishal?
No, I think that's it. Gurmeet. I think the key takeaway for me in the last 2-3 months that I've been noticing is that one, how do I get the best buck? And this is all what advertisers are saying, right? How do you get the best buck out of the money that you currently spend? And how well can we precisely target? And which one is the outcome to the other, right? One is the means to the end. So the better and sharper way we can target, the better the outcomes for the campaigns and so on and so forth. I think that's the crux of it all, essentially.
Yep. Thank you very much, Vishal. Thank you for your time and thank you for joining us. So on the spirit, on the note which you kind of set, you know, that how do we kind of evaluate? Let's you know, move on to the, you know, next panelist to, you know, figure out how Quora can be useful. So Michelle, passing it back to you, and a big thank you again.
Thank you so much, Gurmeet. Thanks, Vishal.
Thank you.
Sure. Thank you for taking us through that. I'd now like to invite, before I invite Nitin Patil and Radhika Okay, who are Quora evangelists, we have a quick poll which is coming up, which will last a few seconds. So we request you all to quickly on, please. We encourage the audience to keep and their questions. At the end of the session, all of your questions will be answered. So please keep typing them in the Q&A box. Nitin, may I invite you to come on board?
Good afternoon, everyone. Hi, Michelle.
Thank you so much, Nitin. Hi. Over to you.
Yep. Thanks, Michelle. Hi guys, good afternoon everyone. So you have been using Quora as users, but today let's cover how Quora is important for businesses. So let's look at the business angle and the advertising angle of Quora. So today, what do we cover on the agenda? We talk about target marketing, why Quora, the audiences on Quora, and how performance campaigns can work on Quora and drive performance for those brands for you. Okay, so starting with the power of target marketing, as rightly said by Gurmeet and Vishal, you know, precision marketing has become important in the today's scenario. Hence, you know, being present at the right time to the right customer in the right context always gives the brand the highest engagement, which in turn leads to, you know, leads to high quality, you know, performance metrics like leads and conversions and sales too. So this helps the brands to, you know, stay focused onto the customers they are looking at, as what Vishal mentioned, targeting the right tribe or the right audiences and collecting that data points and, you know, reaching out to them. So this helps the brand to, you know, be focused onto their communication, to their objectives, to what they want to achieve from their digital campaigns. So hence target marketing becomes an important aspect in today's marketing scenario. So that's how Quora could help brands be there and leverage. So why Quora and why do people come to Quora? Okay, so basically Quora, people come to share their knowledge and learn about the world. That's precisely the mission of Quora, which Adam Angelo, the first CTO of Facebook, started Quora in 2009 with a platform where people could share their knowledge. So people come here across for different perspective. People come here to evaluate products. They come and conduct researches on different topics. They're trying to find communities which are there on Quora, which resonates to their knowledge, their thought process, the passion which they have. They try and find out like-minded people on Quora through the communities. They increase and share their knowledge. They share their stories across. They get surprised by the local content, global content, which they could read and access through. Well, as they can go as hyper-local as possible and ask something, questions within their own community or their own locality itself. So Quora gives the user the perspective of, reading global content to a very hyper-local and a very local content also. So people come here across different objectives and start surfing Quora for gaining knowledge. So where does Quora lie? So Quora has a perfect hybrid straddling between social and search. As I said, people come, start passively browsing content, they start reading. They also start searching and evaluating products. So hence Quora becomes a perfect amalgamation of social and search. Okay, that's how where Quora lies upon. So we are a hybrid of social and search platforms. Now coming to the audience, how do we look at the audience on Quora? If you see that we have a perfect split of age groups on Quora. Precisely you could look at targeting the millennials, you can look at targeting the decision makers and the people who have the purchase intent. So Quora has about 80% of its audience between 18 to 44. So which gives a breakup of millennial audience of 35%, 40% of purchase intent driven audiences and a higher audience with the rest 20%. So it gives you a perfect split of different genders which you could target. Though Quora doesn't collect the this data of gender, the age groups, but it's done through a Nielsen study and hence the bifurcation. So Quora is a very neutral platform and talks to both the genders. Hence you can see an equal split of male and female audience coming onto our platform. That's precisely because Quora has a policy called BNBR, which is be nice, be respectful to the users. That is the policy which helps us abide by the users, which gives an equal and a neutral split on gender. Coming to the split, if you see, Quora has an equal split of, you can see that there's a mobile percentage which is there. So we are present heavily on mobile compared to a desktop, and that's been a global standard across all the apps today. We are being heavy in the mobile space. Coming to the audience, which is precisely the biggest point over here, which is 40 minutes time spent and outbeats the average time spent of all the platforms today across. And you see a high engagement of users on our site. So on the app, so 40 minutes of time spent on the app and 15 minutes to the mobile search, which comes to Quora. Coming to the unduplicated growth, Quora has a unique audience on its websites, which is there. So if you compare it with the leading platforms from, like LinkedIn, Twitter, and Facebook, 74% of Quora's audience is unique and is not available on LinkedIn. Hence, we have a high reach compared to Twitter. 80% of our audience is unique and not available on Quora. So you tend to reach a very unique and a different audience through Quora. Looking at the year-on-year growth, our audience sizes have been growing drastically. We have about 75% which we grew on last year. Number of questions and answers percentage is increasing, shows the interaction rate and the traction the platform is having. So that's how the audience looks on Quora. Quora has the nature of content on Quora is basically through question and answers. So these question and answers are tagged to the various topics on Quora. So And you can talk to people on precisely surfing these particular topics. So Quora has about 4 lakh plus topics available on Quora. So on the slide, what you can currently see a few topics and the numbers which are there for India. These are the India numbers. So let me pick a few of them. You know, if you look at the technology as a topic, it has about 71 million followers and about 1 million questions being asked, which is a huge community to look at. Similarly, you know, you can look at, you know, cricket, which is right now IPL being, you know, being announced and going to start tomorrow. So cricket has about, you know, 4 million followers and about 2 lakh questions being asked. So likewise, there are about different topics available on Quora where people engage and read content on Quora. So let's deep dive on a few of the important topics or a few topics which can give you a perspective about Quora. Coming to finance as a topic, you see that there are about 31 million answer views and about, you know, 21 million followers which are there. Likewise, when you look at insurance as a category, you have about 5 million answer views. So that's the engagement you have on Quora. Coming to banking, banking being the biggest of all the categories, you see 31 million followers and about 3 lakh questions being asked. So this is about the BFSI as a category. Looking at education, this is one of the most popular topics on Quora and the most sorted topics where users come across. That's precisely, you have about 1 million questions being asked on education. So people come here to understand which universities to join, which courses to join, which is a better course to look at, to pursue, which universities are there to pursue. So hence education is the one of the biggest topics and one of the biggest categories to look at on Quora. Compared, we also look at software and SaaS as a product. People do come here and engage. You have people talking to businesses, where B2B people come here, learn about different aspects, right from, you know, startups to, you know, getting investments to, you know, knowing about GST rules and regulation, what are the government regulations. So people come here and talk on different topics. Hence, you can capture these audiences in the right context and the right time frame. And hence, moving on, and how brand can leverage Quora. Precisely, you can look at, you know, there are three types of where you can leverage. One is the text ads and the image ads. Second is promoted answers. Third is through business profiles and an amalgamation of promoted answers. So let's deep dive onto each of these aspects. So text ads are basically a native ad in format, which is available on Quora. It has a headline, a body copy, and a CTA. We suggest, brands when they are looking at advertising to text ads, have the headlines in a question format, which, you know, perfectly, amalgates with the format of Quora. Okay. So text ad is one of the ad units which you can leverage. At the same time, you can look at the image ads. So image ad has a hero image at the center, followed on the top with the brand name, the headline copy, the logo, and then you have the body copy. So there are about 16 different CTAs which you can use perfectly basis your objective of the campaign, right from an awareness to a traffic to installs to you're looking at a lead or a performance. So you can use these different types of CTA buttons which are available on Quora. Coming to promoted answer, which is the third ad unit, promoted answer gives you a more real estate to talk about a product and services. It helps the brand, you know, establish a thought leadership for themselves and help them, you know, grow the top funnel awareness for the brand. So you can, the brands can come and answer, certain questions and have themselves, discuss about their products and services. So how do brands leverage and how brands can look at Quora? Let's look at the Quora flywheel. So brands can come, share their content, share their perspective on the products and services, thus giving an engagement by the users, by, you know, upvotes, shares and comments, and, you know, thus delivering and establishing a thought leadership for themselves. So though this being an organic approach, promoted answer gives an acceleration to this particular entire process. So if you, you know, promote an answer, this will help you grow your reach organically well within the system and give you that reach, relevance and frequency for your answers and the content which you want to disseminate onto the users. Okay. So how do you look at promoted answers? There are different types of promoted answers where you could look at. One is how brands are answering on Quora, and the second one is having surrogate profiles of the leadership team answering certain numbers, answering certain questions on Quora, and leveraging that through promoted answers. So here you can see an example of how IBM has been talking to the developer community. So they are taking a leadership stance or a thought process stance and, you know, giving the information to the developer community, whereas you can see Gabriel Weinberg, who is the CEO of DuckDuckGo, which is an alternative search engine, talking about the search engine and the product and the services. So brand themselves can directly start doing promoted answers, well as, you know, they can have the leadership team or any author to write content for them and promote that across. Okay. Brands can also leverage, you know, having a profile on Quora, which is called as Quora Business Profile Page. So on the left-hand side, you can see how Lovery, which is one of the brands, you know, having a brand profile page on Quora and having a one-stop destination for themselves to, you know, leverage more content to the users, give more content and talk to the users on the Quora ecosystem. Whereas they, you can see on the right-hand side, you have an user profile or could be a leadership profile, which can be later used for promoted answers. So brands can look at creating a business profile, whereas a thought leadership, you know, surrogate profiles for them. Okay. So on promoted answers, though text is one of the way of writing answers, you can also have videos embedded into it and GIF images also embedded into it. You can embed a YouTube video which plays within the Quora ecosystem. Well, as you know, the video views gets accurate to the video platform which you are running the video through. So you can use from a, you know, different types of you know, context to in promoted answers. You can use a text, you can use video, you can use GIF, and, you know, have more engagement with your users. Okay. Quora also has a performance driven product, which is called as the lead gen, which helps you to get an leads on Quora within the same ecosystem. So you don't have to drive the users to an external landing page where you have the leads captured, where the lead gen form on Quora is perfectly well built within Quora itself, and the users can directly submit their details, and, you know, the brands can collect those leads for their performance campaigns. So looking at this, you know, let's look at the targeting options available on Quora, how you can target these users, what and how you can monitor your campaigns, to which are the brands which are leveraging on Quora. So may I ask Radhika to, you know, take you through the targeting options available on Quora. So Radhika?
Yeah, thank you, Nitin.
Yeah.
Okay, so thank you, Nitin. So I'll now help you understand how you can reach your target audience, right? So there are primarily four types of targeting that Quora offers, right? There's contextual targeting, there's audience targeting, there's behavioral targeting, and there's broad targeting, right? I'll come into each one in detail. Apart from these, you can also layer in device targeting. That is, if you want to target specific devices like iOS or Android, then we have gender targeting. Then we have location targeting, wherein you can choose locations at country, state, city, and zip code level. And we have browser targeting, where you can choose specific browsers to target, like Chrome, Mozilla, etc. Right? Apart from these, you can also exclude certain locations, certain questions, keywords, and audiences as well. Right? Now I'll come into each one in detail, right? So contextual targeting, like the name suggests, matches your ads to relevant content that users are reading on Quora, right? And contextual targeting on Quora is real time. So when I say real time, I mean, for example, like you're reading about mutual funds as a topic, right? Right now on Quora, that's when your ad will show, right? Contextual targeting has three types of targeting within them. There's topic targeting, there's keyword targeting, and there's question targeting, right? Topic targeting is when you can show your ads to relevant topics that you think users will be reading on Quora about, which is related to your business, right? For example, mutual funds as a topic, if I'm reading about it right now, that's when your ad will show, right? Then there's keyword targeting. Keyword targeting is where you can put in your top performing keywords, and these will target questions which match those keywords and show your ads real time, right? So here we usually suggest that you use your top performing keywords from Google, because you know Quora is relative to Google, right? Then we have question targeting. So question targeting is where you there are these pre-existing questions on Quora which you can choose to target, and your ads will show to them, right? So that's contextual. So like I told you, contextual targeting is real-time targeting on Quora, right? Next, we move to behavioral targeting. So now the major difference between contextual and behavioral targeting is the fact that while contextual is real-time, behavioral is based on user behavior, basically interest shown previously. So for example, 2 days before, I've read about mutual funds. Therefore, I've shown interest on that topic, right? Therefore, the ad will show to me, right? Within behavioral targeting, there are three types of targeting. There's interest targeting, there's keyword history targeting, and there's question history targeting. So interest targeting is where you can target a set of topics that is relevant to your business, and your ads will show to users who previously shown interest on that topic, right? Then keyword history targeting. So this is similar to keyword targeting, wherein you can choose to put in your top performing keywords, and based on interest shown previously by users on those keywords, it'll target your ad to those questions, right? Similar to that is question history targeting, wherein again, you can choose from a set of pre-existing questions that's relevant to your business, and based on interest previously shown by users, your ads will show to those users, right? So like I told you, contextual is real time and behavioral is based on interest, right? Now we come to audience targeting. So audience targeting comes into picture when you want to retarget your existing users, right? So there are three types of audiences you can target on Quora. There's website traffic audience, where you can target users who've already landed on your page or specific pages of your website. Then there's lookalike audience, where you can target audience lookalikes of your existing users. And there's list match, where you can upload a list of email IDs of the users you want to target, right? And finally, we have broad targeting. Now, you can use this when you want maximum eyeballs, right? Use this when you want to target a larger audience to drive awareness or traffic to your brand, and we'll target to across the Quora audience, right? So these are the four major targeting methods that we have on Quora. Now we move to bidding, right? So we have three bidding methods available on Quora. There's cost per click, CPC, cost per thousand impressions, CPM, and cost per action, CPA, right? CPC is when you start advertising on Quora, we usually suggest that you start with CPC. Basically, just like other platforms, you define your maximum CPC you're willing to pay, and you'll be charged per click, right? Then we have CPM, where your goal is to get maximum impressions, or let's say your goal is branding, then you can choose this bidding where you pay for 1,000 impressions, right? Then we have cost per action. So let's say you start your campaign with a specific conversion goal, like app installs, leads, or sale, and you want it at a certain cost, right? That's when you choose this bidding. But here again, we suggest that you start with CPC, and once you have enough number of conversions, say about 50 to 100, then you can shift to CPA, right? So like Gurmeet and Vishal mentioned earlier also, at every stage of your marketing funnel, you can target Quora, right? So for example, let's say you're launching a new phone. You can choose brand awareness as your objective, and you can place image ads and then target the broad targeting, right? Then comes your consideration phase. So where you can give information about the product and its features through promoted answers and target specific topics and questions that you want to. And then comes last the purchase funnel, right? Where you can place our purchase pixels, Quora pixels, and then we can start tracking your purchases, right? So these are our targeting methods and our bidding methods. So all of this is possible with our Quora Ads Manager. So with our QAM, you can create campaigns, monitor performance of your campaigns, monitor your conversions, create reports, and a lot more things that you can do, right? It's a very simple platform. Once you start using it, you'll actually fall in love with it. So these are some of the partners that we've tied up with, which will help you track your performance at a deeper level. And here are some of our top advertisers who have had amazing results. So if you'd like to get started on Quora, you can contact us on any of these email IDs mentioned here, and we should get you enabled soon. especially with the festive season coming up, it's the right time to target Quora. So with that, we come to the end of our presentation.
Thank you, Radhika. Thank you so much. Radhika, we have one question for you, which is coming from the audience. And they'd like to know if you can explain audience targeting in detail.
Sure. So shall I present my screen again?
Yes, yes.
I'll do that. So yeah, coming back to audience targeting. So these are the three ways you can audience target, right? There's website traffic audience. So when you choose website traffic audience as an option to target, you can choose specific pages that you want, that users have come on Quora, on your website. And if you can also choose to target your entire web page, right? That's website traffic audience. So what happens is once you choose that, Quora will populate the audience that's landed on your website in a span of maybe 90 days or whatever you specify, and then you can target, right? So let's say it might show up some 45,000 audiences. Then you can target all of them, and as a remarketing method, you can target it, right? Then we have lookalike audience. So when I say lookalike audience, let's say, so you have chosen specific pages of your website, right? Or your website. So you want to create a lookalike of your website traffic audience, you can do that. Or let's say you put in a list of email IDs that you wanted to target, and let's say populate up to some 1 million users for you to target, you can create a lookalike of that. The good thing of doing that is you are not only reaching to your audience who's landed on your page or you've uploaded as an email ID, you're also reaching out to audiences who look alike like your audiences, right? Like the audiences who've landed on your page. Is that clear or do you want more context?
Radhika, thank you. Okay, so with that, we come to the end of the session. Nitin, Radhika, thank you so much for deep diving into the entire concept of target marketing. I think it's been a very interactive and informative session for all the audience. We've had some Q&A which have come in and which have been answered by the Quora team. So thank you for that. Gurmeet and Vishal, thank you as well for your time. Before we sign off, Sagar, can we quickly have the poll results, please? So there you go. What kind of a platform is Quora? Search, social, neither, both. So we have social taking 26% the cake and both taking 47%. So Radhika, are we right on that?
Yeah.
We are. Great. Sagar, can we have the next question? What kind of ad targeting is available on Quora? All of the above says 84%.
Perfect.
Great. So I think then that's perfectly done. We've managed to capture our audience as well and get them all the information that they need. To the audience, Radhika has already shared her screen where she had shared the email IDs, etc. You can also get in touch with us at Exchange for Media, and we're more than happy to put you in touch with the Quora team. Once again, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you to the entire Quora team once more, and see you all soon at another webinar. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.